As another example, I want to show you the architecture of the iRODS system. This is a data grid system that was built by a biologist, and it's a system for storing and accessing big data. So what I'm going to do the same thing that I did for the Linux system. I'm going to show you here on the left-hand side this clean prescriptive architecture for the iRODS system. And I'm going to show you here on the right the actual architecture of the system, the descriptive architecture of iRODS. So here, even if we don't go and look at the details, you can see very easily that the system is badly drifted and eroded with respect to the way it was supposed to be. Continuing with the examples, what I want to show you now is a view of the complete architecture of Hadoop. As many of you probably already know, Hadoop is an open source software framework for storage and large-scale processing of datasets. It's very broadly used. And here is a picture of the architecture. And I hope you can see it, because the architecture is so complex, so broad, and so intertwined, that in order to be able to represent it here in one page, I had to zoom out quite a bit. But also in this case, you don't really have to look at details. The important point here is that in this software architecture, 61 out of the 67 components in the system have circular dependencies, which means that they depend on each other in a circular way. And this is normally not a good thing. And also in this case, a few developers, when shown the diagram, had no idea that the structure of the system was so complex and messy.